Us YouTubers, and welcome back to your soon-to-be scheduled reviews by none other than Hot Goggles. Today we'll be reviewing...
Happy birthday!
It's not my birthday. Oh, Satan, it's just you. What do you want?
To take your mortal soul.
Silly Satan, I'm not immortal.
Really? Well, then. You're not even mine.
That's Satan, always wanting my immortal soul. Oops. Okay, let's get started with Kazue Kato's Ao no Exorcist, or Blue Exorcist. Now, it's a normal manga with a normal plot, so it needs other things to make it better. Well, let's get started. The main protagonist, Ren Okamura, finds out that he is a demon, but not just any demon, but the son of Satan! Anyway, after finding that out, he ends up joining a holy group that's out to kill him and any other demon that they come across, just so he's able to become more stronger to protect his loved ones. We've all heard this story before. Excuse me. Anyway, with the story as bland as this, well, any story's bland once you get to the roots, but this story's been used as a subplot for most other mangas anyway, so let's just dive in and find out what makes it better. Okay guys, here's where the real difference comes in. Unlike other stories where the main character might have a half-sibling, in this one they have a twin brother. I feel that this will bring new character depth and I like the change of pace. And unlike other stories involving Satan where he just wants to blow shit up, this one, he actually wants to rule the earth. That's the main focus of this, because apparently our main protagonist has demon blood and lives in our human world, while the devil, whenever he seems to come here, things just start dying and breaking apart. The devil seems to have some ulterior motive, where he needs a real body to function in the human world and, you know, just not bust shit up. Personally, if I have any real problems with the plot, I feel that it just moves way too slowly. I mean, it took them over a year to have a real villain besides the devil who's just lurking in the shadows, like the almighty threat that he is. But I mean, like, it took them over a year to have a real main villain. But to be fair, they cut out villain plot with personal plot, which I can commend them for that, so that's something. Okay, for characters, we have the idiot with the sword, the gun-slinging younger twin brother with a weak spirit, the questionably good guy who knows and controls everything, the healer, the bitch, the proud overachiever, the wimp, the perv, the prick, the drunk bitch, I mean, mentor, and finally the badass old man who the rest can never overcome. Oh yeah, the cat. It's cute. Yeah, so the characters don't really get much deeper than that. They all play their roles well, and they don't go beyond anything that you would expect. So, don't expect too much. But I do like how Ren and his younger twin brother, Yukio, react to each other. And it's nice to see how Yukio is affected by his brother being a demon, and how he pretty much knew about it the whole time. Because it's kind of hard to tell how he really feels about it sometimes. Sometimes he seems like he wants to protect him, other times he feels like he just wants to just not deal with it. Oh, wait, I forgot. The mentor. She answers the question about hammer space. It's not up their skirts, it's in their cleavage. Alright, so the art's up to date with anything that's came out past 2005. It looks very simple without many lines and is very clean. It's light, but that could be the fact that there is absolutely no background some of the times. It's either just a white background or a black background, but the background shots of scenery that they do give you look really nice. Now, this manga being with demons related does use a bunch of Christianity symbols, but this manga realizes that Christianity isn't the only religion out there. You do get to see other religions. And for a manga that doesn't have that much of a realistic style, the demons do look pretty scary, and I like that. Oh yeah, and the fire. This is the first time I felt fire look different in any manga I've seen. I like fire. Okay, now there's nothing really different about this manga that you haven't read before. I mean, it's what you'd expect from this type of manga with this type of plot. But if there's anything that I do like about it, it's actually funny, unlike all those other manga. I need to get that checked out. But yeah, that's pretty much all you're gonna find here. Though I do like the art, and it's nice attention to detail, especially when Ren gets mad and his eyes starts to swirl up a little bit like flames. And you can also see that in the bubble texts too, which I find nice, because people don't really tend to pay attention to those, but the bubbles that they use do look different, and I like that. Alright viewers, and the score I Don't Know Exorcist gets is a 3.5 out of 5. That's because this story has been seen many times before, as I told you, and it's very bland and hardly brings anything new to the table. But because it does have that concept of twins, and one of them not having powers that may have happened, but I don't really remember seeing it in any other manga, I like to find that originality makes it a step above the others. And I feel that even though its plot is a bit slow, it still has many things that it can work out and will bring us. I feel that this manga will become something greater within the future.